How are you all? Hope you're fine with the grace of the Almighty God. So, students, we have already started the explanation of the chapter, that is chapter 1 from the geography part, and this is class 6 social studies. And our topic of the chapter is Earth in the Solar System. So, we have already discussed the various topics, and right now we are going to head towards the solar system. If you did not watch the part 1 video, then part 1 video is already be given in the WhatsApp link. WhatsApp link has been given in the WhatsApp. Go and click on that link and watch the video and come and watch this video. If you did not watch it, the first part of the video, go and watch the first part of the video, then come to watch the second part of the video. So otherwise you will not be able to understand that what I have explained. So before heading forward, I'll just read the chapter and I will go to forward that solar system. The reading I will do because of just for revision. So what we are going to learn in this video is about the evolutions of the universe, constituents of the universe, constituents of the solar system, condition that makes the Earth a unique planet. So as we know that our Earth is a very unique planet because of the celestial body, that is heavenly body. So let us find the if you see in the night, that question was given that if you see at night, that what did you notice, that stars twinkle, or how did it happen? So we will find the answer based to the question. That is the first step which is given. So let us read about the universe. I have explained already this universe. This is just a revision video. For this reason I'll be just reading the video, means reading the lines. And if you want the explanation of the lines, then go and watch the first part of the video. The first part of the video has been already been forwarded in your group. So universe, the sun, the moon and the stars that we see in the sky are called celestial body, that is heavenly body. They are the part of the universe. The universe is a vast space which is believed to be formed with the big explosion known as a Big Bang theory. So according to this theory, the universe was formed nearly about 13.8 billion years ago, when a huge burning ball of fire consisting matter such as gases, dust particles and other elements exploded with a big bang. Due to this explosion, all the matter from it was thrown out with a great force in all the direction. The tiny particles grouped together and formed atoms, which are the smallest particles of element matter. So then these atoms came together to form the galaxies, and there are billions of the galaxies in the universe. Each galaxy is a huge collection of the gas and billions of the stars along with their solar system. So stars, now we are going to read. Okay, so celestial bodies which are made up of the hot gases and which produce their own heat and light are called stars. The sun and that we see in the sky is one among the billions of the stars in the galaxy called Akash Ganga or Milky Way. Now the stars we see from the Earth during the night are the other stars of the Milky Way. So they appear so small because they are very far away from the Earth, but still we get the light. Okay, they are the main sources of the heat and light for the other planets also. So constellation we are going to learn. As I have already told, that constellation is just dependent upon the imaginations. Okay, so the group of the stars that appears to form the pattern in the sky is called what? Constellation. And there are 88 constellations in the sky. Ursa Major, Big Dipper or the Great Bear is one of them. It is also called Saptarishi in India. There are 7 stars in the constellation which form the shape of the big spoon. The 2 stars at the end of the constellation are called pointers, which take towards some directions, which shows the directions at night. And they also point towards the pole star. So the other famous constellations are Usha Minor, Orion, Scorpius and Hydra. So just for the revision, I have read the chapter. Now we are going to understand by the explanation from the solar system. If we say about the solar system, the Latin word sol means what? Sun. Okay, the Latin word sol means what? Sun. And system refers to its family. What is system? Solar system. So we are saying, you know, sol means sun, and system refers to what? Family. In other words, the solar system is the family of the sun. So if we say, in other words, what is solar system? The solar system is the family of the sun. Okay, so it consists of the sun, the 8 planets, satellites, asteroids, meteoroids and comets. So the it has eight planets which are satellites, okay? Eight planets, and they has also got the solar system has got eight planets. They has got asteroids. Asteroids, you know, no, that it is a big ball, you can say. It is a very huge, gigantic ball. We are also afraid of this asteroid, because if an asteroid means comes and strikes with the Earth, we know that there will be very big explosion. But the size of the asteroid should be larger, okay? The small size of the asteroid is looking as a that we are saying at night, that toota hua tara, right? That the sun means the Earth, when the stars, okay, when they break down and fall on the Earth, okay, they are also a part of the asteroids. But if the larger size of the asteroids will be there, it will destroy also to us. So we are afraid of that. So meteors and comets are there. Let us study in detail about each of them. Okay, we will study of the detail about each of them. Okay. Now the sun lies at the center of the solar system. As we know, the sun is at the center of the solar system, as we can see in this image, right? We can see in this image that the sun is at the center of the solar system, and the other planets are following to it. Okay, so the sun lies at the center of the solar system. It is the largest member. You can see it is the largest member of the solar system. The gravitational pull of the sun holds the other member of the solar system in the place. So you can see on the screen that the due to the means the sun only, other planets are standing on their way. So how this they are standing? Because the sun is pulling others, okay? It is holding others tightly. You can say that it is holding other tightly. For this reason, it is making the gravitational force. What is gravitational force? So you may think, what is gravitational force? The gravitational force is depending upon the gravity or weight of the body. If our weight of the body is more, then everything, suppose a ball also, if anything you see, if we throw, what will happen? It will fall in the ground only, right? So the gravitational, it is due to the gravitational force, okay? This is called the gravity. So the temperature of the surface of the sun is about 6000 degrees Celsius. We are saying about the surface of the sun is about 6000 degrees Celsius. But if you go to the middle of the sun, okay, as we are in the middle of the Earth, right? We are inside the Earth. So if you go inside the sun, the temperature will go up to, you cannot imagine also, that is that is 150, it is given. But if you can stay in the short, right, that it is up to 15 crore, okay, that is 15 crore degrees Celsius, okay. 15 crore degrees Celsius. That is too much. I know. Our bones and nothing we will get, right? So we will be completely be burned up. So we cannot go near to it also. We cannot imagine also going too near to it, right? Like 6000 degrees Celsius only will be enough to burn us. 15 lakh crore is not required. 15 crore is not required. So being made up of the extremely hot gases, it is the source of the heat and light from the planet. So you see that the sun and the earth distance is a very perfect combination. For this reason, we are getting the heat and light of the sun, okay? And also we can say that the distance between this and the earth and the sun is a very perfect distance. For this reason, what we are getting, the heat of the sun, okay, in the very perfect adequate amount, that is in the perfect amount, not less also, not more also. If we get more amount of the sunlight, what will happen? It is a destruction for us, okay? However, due to the distance of the earth from the sun, that is 150 million kilometer, we do not feel the tremendous heat of the sun. So the how much far? That is 150 million means kilometer far. We are far from the sun, 115 million kilometer from the sun. So for this reason, that is why we are not feeling that much hot. Otherwise, if the distance between the earth and the sun would be like Hawley and Borpeta, then we would not be existed today, okay? So light from the sun takes about 8 minutes to reach earth surface. So how much 8 minutes it takes? Light from the sun, it takes nearly 8 minutes to reach to the earth surface, okay? So as we know that the light means fast, travels faster than the sound, okay? For this reason, light takes how much minute? It takes nearly 8 minutes to travel into the Earth surface, okay? So planets, now we are going to study. So next is about the planets we will study. So this will be the second part of the video, and this the second part of the video I will teach up to planets only. Then I will made a third part of the video. So the word planets is derived from the Greek word that is means of word that is planet is among the wanderer. Okay, wanderer means we cannot imagination. It is depend upon the imagination because the word planet is also that earth is a heavenly body. If you think about the planet that or the planet is formed, this all is in the imagination that this thing happened for this reason the earth is formed. But that there is no perfect theory that defines the these things. There are eight planets in the solar system on the earth on the basis of their distance from the sun. They are all already you can see here. Okay, already you can see in the down that there are eight planets, and they are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. The planets close to the sun are called inner planets. The planets which are close to the sun, okay, are called what? The close to the sun planets are called inner planets, and this include they are nearly you can say that Mercury, Venus, Earth is also there, and Mars. Okay, so Mars, okay, these are also you can say this is a Mars. These are called what? Inner planets. They include, I have already told, they are made up of the rocks and are also called terrestrial planets. So this type of the which four planets which I have told, the four planets, the first four planets after the sun, they are also called the terrestrial planet. The rest four planets, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, which are so outer planets, they are made up of the you can say that is gases also, and this is are also called gas giant. Lots of the gases are present. For this reason it is also some that Neptune is the coldest of all. All these planets do not have the heat and light of their own. Okay, this they not have their heat and light of their own, but they reflect the sun's light, right? So they revolved around the sun in the fixed elongated paths called orbits, which they are, if you are seeing looking that one, they are rotating on there, that is the fixed elongated path, right? These are what called, these are fixed path you can say. While revolving, the planets are also rotate on the axis. So they every planets of the solar system take its respective time to rotate and revolve around the sun. Though all the planets are spherical in shape, however they have the distinctive features. So if you can see here that all the planets are the surrounding shape, but they have their different features are also there. They rotate on their own axis. Axis are the fixed part through which the planets rotate. Okay, each and every planets have their own axis. So students, what we did, you learn about the chapter is that now we you can say about the unique features of the planet is mentioned at the down of the chapter, that is Mercury is the smallest and the closest planet to the sun. Venus is the brightest and the hottest planet is there. Earth is the blue planet. Mars is the red planet. So these are what, these are the planets, and they are the having the unique features. That's the Jupiter you can say is the biggest planet of all as we know, and Saturn, which is the planet with the largest number of the rings around it. Uranus is there, and ice giant is there. Then the Neptune is the farthest planet from the sun. So now we are going to study about the Earth, but this will be the next part of the video. This will be very interesting because we are staying in it and we are also the part of the Earth, and then we will come to know about the various topics. One more or two videos will be made, then our explanation will get over, then we'll move forward to the question answers, then the geography chapter 1 will get over, then we will go to the chapter 2, then we will learn about the latitudes and the longitudes. So before doing that, we need to finish everything. I hope that you are studying well in your house, and keep studying, keep enjoying the classes, keep looking the videos, and keep updating yourself. I hope that you will attend the live classes, and live classes is going to help you a lot. Till then, that take care. Thank you. Bye bye. But before saying bye bye, I would like to say that please attend the live classes regularly because it is going to help you a lot. I hope that you are writing each and every question answers in your copy. Make a separate copy for each and every subjects like geography and history, then social and political life. These are the parts of the social studies, right? So you make the parts of the social studies, then you study it. Okay, so till then, that take care. Thank you. Bye bye.